And I never know what to say, like, when you guys ask that, because there's so many stories. I remember when I went to school, I was super, super quiet. I did not speak the first whole year.
Hola, amigos. So for today's video, we have some drunken tofu noodles. I don't know. It has a weird name, and I will tell you guys the story later. But yeah, it's called the drunken noodles. And then hopefully this video won't get demonetized because of the name. And then we have some kimchi here. First time eating American kimchi. I'm excited. I've tried it actually the other day. But it's the first time in a video. And then I have some baby carrots just to keep it healthy. So I'm actually just going to get started straight away. Ooh, look guys. This is udon noodles. And it's supposed to be very spicy. And we shall wrap it around like the cool people do. That is so good. I will leave the recipe down below, guys. It's amazing. Very spicy. Ooh. I had to put in like 1 whole tablespoon of sriracha sauce. Oh my god. That's making my insides really warm. Then we have kimchi over here. I love kimchi, guys. This one is not my favorite. I've tried better ones in the Philippines, but it's still very good actually. Yesterday when I tried it out, I really hated the taste. Anyways, the reason why it's called drunken noodles is because they think at least that in the beginning when they created this, there was a guy who was drunk and then he made it when he was drunk. So he just tossed in everything he could find in the house with noodles and then stir fried it and then ate that, and it became successful, like a successful recipe. So that's why they call it the jungle noodles, or at least that is what they think. The shout out of the day goes to Constantly Whelmed. Go down below guys and say hi to him or her. And if you want a shout out, just subscribe and tell me down below when you've done it, and I will give you a shout out. The kimchi is spicy. This is spicy. Everything is spicy. So, since I'm going back to the Philippines in January, and a lot of you guys have been asking me like about stories about the Philippines, and I never know what to say like when you guys ask that, because there's so many stories. But I still get so many questions on Instagram and Twitter about school in the Philippines, what it's like to study in the Philippines. What it was like for me. And I love onion and garlic. And there's tons in this dish. Vampires are going to stay away from me now. When I came to the Philippines, I did not know how to speak Tagalog in the beginning. So I was basically a foreigner. Like, I guess I was really, but I'm half Filipina, so I'm like not really a foreigner there, but kind of also because I didn't grow up there. So it was a huge like culture shock. And I remember when I went to school, I was super, super quiet. I did not speak the first whole year. Very rarely spoke in my class. And I only did it when I had to. And most of them had never like heard me speak. The first, like, it was in 6th grade, was not the best. Like, my classmates were very nice and stuff, but I was way too like scared. But something that was like huge for me was the food in the school. Like, it was so different from Sweden. The food in the school cafeteria, insane. Because it was so bizarre to me, because they were selling hot dogs, chips, junk food, like tons of junk food. And I was like, in Sweden, they would never allow that. So I got like so confused with it. Because in Sweden, you're not even allowed to like drink, or at least not in my school, you weren't even allowed to drink soft drinks in school. Like, they were like very OCD with their and the health of the students, so they would never let us drink soft drinks, or we weren't even allowed to bring candy to school. We were only allowed to bring sweets to school on the days where they tell us that we could, like on Halloween and stuff. So when I was in the Philippines, I was like, oh my god, it's allowed to eat candy. And it's so funny because there's a type of chips in the Philippines which is very similar to Takis, where their fingers would get so red, and it's not actually chips but it's french fries, which is like filled with cheese, like powdered cheese. I don't know why it's in the color red, but their fingers would be red, their lips would be red, like everyone would smell like french fries in school. And I was so confused by that. And another thing that was confusing was my classmates were so thin, like so many of them were thin. There were some who were a little bit bigger, but a lot of them were thin, and I was like, how are you thin and you eat so much junk food? But it's because the portions were very small, like the portions of the food was very very small, so I guess that's why. Speaking of the food, for the first whole year I would order from the school, so, or for the half of the first year, so I would order from school, and it would be basically, I think they had like maybe 20 types of foods, so each week, no, I think it was like the same every Monday, it was the same every Tuesday, it was the same, you know. I remember on Mondays, first, I don't remember the day yet, but let's say on Mondays we would get like pork chop. I would like it and everything, but it was a very tiny meal and we'd only be fed like once. So I was very hungry when I got home, because classes, another thing, like classes start sometimes at 7:30 a.m. and then ends at 4 p.m. It was insane. Like, I would be in school the whole day. And in Sweden, sometimes we would begin at 9 a.m. and then end at 2 p.m. So, and also our recess would be very long. But in the Philippines, it's like, you have to study a lot. And that also shocked me. Like, the school system is so different. You would, in the Philippines, first grade in the Philippines, it's like high school material for other countries. It's, that's why like so many Asians are super super smart, because they teach this the kids really young. And that wasn't the case for me, because I grew up in Sweden, so like the math was very advanced, everything was advanced, and I had a very hard time keeping up with everything. Thankfully I did pass though, but I was like, did not have the best grades at all. The first school I went to was very close to our home, so I didn't have to take the school bus. I just used a tricycle, and I will insert a photo of a tricycle right now. And it's really fun to ride on those, but it can get like really smelly because you're low to the ground, so you can smell all of the pollution and stuff. But yeah, so that was like my first year. My first year like in the Philippines for 6th grade, it was very like quiet because I didn't speak a lot. But my classmates were very very nice. Like, that's one big thing about the Philippines, like it's so rare that people would get bullied in school there. They would always treat you good no matter who you are, and I really admire that about the Filipinos. So anyways, the second year, so my first year of high school, I decided I would be a bit more brave. So what I did was, on the very first day of high school, I decided I would just speak right away, because I had a weird theory. Because when I went to grade 6, I was very quiet. And then when I finally learned Tagalog, I didn't want to speak it in school, because I didn't want my classmates to see the development. I didn't want a big reaction and stuff. So that's why I thought that if I switched school, fresh beginning, nobody knew who I was, then they wouldn't have to see like the transition part of me learning a new language. So it wouldn't be that awkward. And my mom, like, she was nice and let me switch schools for the first year of high school. When I went to this school, on the very first day, as soon as I found a person, I spoke to them, just to break the cycle of not speaking in school. And so the first person I spoke to was the register, I think, because I didn't know which line I would be in, because there were different classes and everyone were like aligned. like in the military. And everyone was standing out there and they looked like so happy and stuff. And then I just asked the register, where am I supposed to be? And that was a huge moment for me because I would never speak to people. So when I did that, I was like, okay, I'm going to survive high school here. Even though my first year of high school was academically the hardest, I've never studied that much in my life, because after school I would not go home. I would go to my tutor, and so after school I would go to school, I would wake up, like, okay, let me tell you my schedule. I would wake up every day Monday to Friday at 4:30 a.m. 4:30 a.m. That's insane. I woke up that early, got ready, school bus came at around 7 a.m. I think, and then we went to school, and we got there when it was like 7:30, because the school was a little bit further away from my house, and also they had to like go in around and around and fetch all of the students. So classes start at 8 a.m. and it's very hardcore there, guys. Start 8 a.m. until around 12, you have lunch. Lunch is for like 45 minutes, I think it was, which was pretty long, which was good, because we were all like super hungry when lunch came around, and everyone, again, like, it was like the food, like, I felt like I was in a grocery store, because you could buy chips and chocolates, and I was like, oh my god, this is crazy. And I definitely did buy the junk food this time. In my first year of high school, I definitely started buying the junk. Anyways, and then classes would end at around 4 p.m. So imagine I was awake from 4:30 a.m. and then classes started, I ended at 4 p.m. and then I wasn't even done yet. I had to go to tutor because my grades wasn't like, they weren't the best, especially with math. So I went to my tutor, stayed with her for like, so I was with her from 4 p.m. until around, sometimes it would be until 8 p.m. I'm not kidding. I went to tutor 4 hours. That's almost like school time. Like, so I was like studying 4 a.m. I was awake 4 a.m. 4:30 a.m. until 8 p.m. That is how long I was like away from home, I guess. Or I guess I went out the door at 7:30, but anyways. And then I would get home at around 8, sometimes 8:30, and then I was like super tired, but all of my homework, or most of them, were done. So that was good. And I did get a little bit better grades because of it, but it wasn't worth it because I wasn't getting any breaks. Like, I wasn't able to breathe or relax or do anything, like extracurricular or nothing. So it was just like school all day long. And so we decided in the second semester to quit tutoring because it was way too much. Like, it would have been okay if I would have gotten like A plus all of the time, or if I would be like finished with all of my homework during that time, but I still had to do homework when I came home. And then I had to sleep early because it would do this whole cycle over and over again. But even though that was the case, my first year of high school was still the best years I've had abroad. So when I say abroad, I mean away from Sweden, because I grew up there. So that was the best time I had in school that wasn't in Sweden, because I finally got friends, so many friends, I feel like. And people were so nice, the teachers were nice, and we had like a little bit of sports, we went out, and I don't know, it was really great and I really enjoyed it. So to the people asking if it will be hard transitioning into a Filipino school, into the Philippines, like if you're a teen or younger and you're moving to the Philippines and you're going there for the first time, which I know like a lot of people are going through that because people, like, their parents are finding jobs in the Philippines. To you guys, I would say do not stress out about it, because it is so easy to get friends in the Philippines. Like, if I could get friends, you can get friends. If you're worried about the academics, it is very, I'm not going to lie to you guys, it's very difficult to get an A in the Philippines. Like, it's almost impossible unless you're really, really, really smart. My grades in the Philippines were not the best. Like, I don't think I've ever gotten an A. Maybe I got an A. Oh, I remember where I got an A. I got an A in penmanship. and in discipline. So like, because I was so behaved, I was like, I even got an award for best behaved award for the year. Like, that was how behaved I was. And I was pretty happy about that, because at least I won something, you know. But other classes I would get C and B. My nose is so itchy. I would mostly get C though, because like, I just could not understand the subjects, even though I really did try. And even when I had a tutor, I would still get C and B. So, but you guys should not worry, because the Philippines, it's awesome. And if you're worried about language, because obviously depends on where you're from and stuff, and if you're half Filipino like me, obviously it was easier for me to learn Tagalog because my mom spoke Tagalog to me when I was younger. And I did know how to speak it when I was really young. I just forgot. So I only had to relearn it. It was like, it's pretty awesome and I really liked it. So if you guys are going there, tell me down below, because I want to talk about it. And oh my god, I even met, or not really met, but I talked to a fellow, like a homeschooler with the same program as me, and that was like insane, because I've never, like, right now I'm homeschooling, guys, and I don't have, like, I don't know anyone who's in the same school as me. So like, she messaged me on Instagram and said that she's going to the same school as me, so we're basically schoolmates. And that was the coolest thing ever, because I wish we had like some sort of forum so we could like talk with other schoolmates, you know, but sadly they don't have that. I thought this would be real spicy. It's not that spicy. I just told my mom, like, if I ever reach 100,000 and I get that plaque thing, oh my god, I'm for sure hanging that up on my wall, because I've never gotten an award. So look guys, it's the last one. I feel like such a little piggy. So we've been looking at like photos of the animal shelter. I didn't want to foster a bunny, but because I'm traveling and stuff, it's not like the best thing to do. And also another thing, my room is carpeted, and if the bunny was to, you know, have accidents, it would be hard to clean that up. But my mom seems to want it though, which is a good sign. But we won't ever adopt, but just foster. It's not really spicy, but it's more on the warm side. I don't know how to explain it, like my throat is getting warm. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please go down below and subscribe to this channel. Or you will turn on the post notifications so you guys know when I upload a new video. Thanks guys. Also follow me on my social media at @RAFFNVC11. Thanks guys. Look at my little, isn't that cute? Thanks for watching guys, gracias por ver, and I will see you guys the next time. Adios. Adios, amigos.